Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. Today's video is going to be on paintbrush care. Now this video is typically going to cover topics like how I maintain, how I wash my brushes and how I even store them. I'm also going to be covering the topic on how I maintain my varnish brushes. This has been, in fact, this video has been requested a couple of times by different viewers, subscribers. So I thought I'll finally go ahead and make one on that. So I really hope you enjoy the content. Do let me know what you think of the video in the comment section. As always, I'll get back to each and every one of you. So let's get started. So to start off with, let's begin with the basic, which is the parts of a brush. I think most of you already are aware of the parts of a brush. I'm just going to be, if you're aware of this, this is going to be a repetition. If you're not aware of it, then well, now you'll know what it is. So this is a basic paintbrush, you see. This is the handle, obviously, the ferrule, and the bristles. Handle, ferrule, bristles. That's it. This is a typical painting scene. What I have already started doing is painting these two beads using these two colors. And you see that I've also used basically these two brushes. I've used this to paint the violet, and I've used this one to paint the ocean green bead. Yeah, both of these beads. Now, the first thing is there's a high chance that, you know, a lot of times we just end up leaving the brush in this manner. What generally tends to happen in this case is that there is a good chance that the brush would start to dry. The paint will start to basically dry on the tip of the brush. So first case, let's take an example in this case. So what I would typically do is, if I know that I'm done with all the painting, if I'm done with the bead painting and all of that, I don't wait. I directly go ahead and wash my brush. So what I typically do is I just quickly give it a rinse like this in one bowl of water. I go on to the second bowl and a double rinse. I test it out and see if there is any amount of paint that is left on the brush. When I know that there isn't, that's it. This brush is clean and I can use it.
So you saw how the double rinse basically helps get rid of at least the paint to a great degree. Now, let me tell you that that is not how I clean at the end of the day's work. No, that's just something that I do typically when I am still having some work, but I don't want the paint to dry. So just give it a quick double rinse, and then at least I know that that paint brush is fine. It's not, it doesn't have paint on it, so it's not going to get hard or the bristles are not going to get affected. But at the end of the day's work, what I typically tend to do is basically give all my brushes that I have used on that particular day a good soap and water cleanup.
So I have the two brushes. I take a little bit of liquid soap in my hands, and with a little bit of water, I just rub the brushes vigorously in my palm, making sure the brushes are clean. I rinse both the brushes thoroughly. And using a paper towel, I wipe them dry. I never leave the brush completely soaking wet. I try to wipe off the excess water as much as I can. And there you go. You're left with two clean brushes. Now, how to clean the brushes when the paint dries on it? Typically, this is a scenario which should be avoided in every case, because when paint dries on the brush, such as this one for example, it just totally deteriorates the quality of the brush. In the long run, the bristles get affected, so please avoid this as much as you can. But in case this happens, what you can do is maybe take a small bowl, fill it with hot water, add in some dishwash or any mild liquid, you can say.
give it a good mix and let the brush actually soak in that water for some time. While I usually don't recommend placing the brush in this kind of a manner for a long duration, currently there is no choice. So, after about 15 minutes, I revisit and I realize that the brush has basically softened up. It's no longer as hard as it was. So it can be now rinsed and all that residual paint can be removed. Hot water, or rather at least warm water, does help get rid of all this residual paint to a great degree. Now I once again add a little bit of liquid soap in my hands and then rinse very well. And if you see, all that residual paint, dried up paint, is starting to show up. But once again, I'd like to repeat that please do not let this situation happen. Do not let paint dry on the brush. Consciously, please remember to wash your brushes on a regular basis. That way, I think the brush just ends up having a longer life. So once everything is washed off, I rinse the brush in warm water. And again, wipe it dry with a paper towel. So if you see, the brushes are again back to being soft. Another practice that I'd usually tend to consciously follow is a lot of times while painting, sometimes you forget that, you know, you probably, okay, you have a paintbrush and it's clean and everything, and you just dunk it in water just like that, with the brush head inward, which is basically in water, in this manner, inside water, and you're kind of forgetting about it. You've just forgotten that, okay, the paintbrush is like that. I never leave my brush in that manner for a long duration. At least I don't do it. It sometimes tends to happen, especially if you're working with multiple brushes and stuff like that. It tends to happen, but this is a big no. What happens to this in this case in the long run is that the brushes will tend to bend, and that's just bad for the brush, and well, you will not be able to also use the brush very efficiently. So that's again a practice which is not to be followed. When it comes to the varnish, this is the product I use. So this one typically is a water-based varnish. So what that means is that it can be diluted with a little bit of water, as well as the cleanup is going to be just soap and water. So it's a pretty straightforward process. I will show you that as well. But if at the same time, if you are using an oil-based varnish, then obviously this method of a water cleanup won't work. You might probably have to use maybe something like an NC thinner or something in order to clean your brushes. So what I always suggest is, before you buy a product, go through the instructions on the package, and it should clearly suggest what you should do and what should be done in order to, say, clean the brushes and stuff like that. So for example, over here with the additional information, one of the things that I was looking at is water-based permanent soap and water cleanup. And that sums it for me. I mean, that's one of the things that I look for, especially in a varnish, say terracotta jewelry. And this is a convenient product, very easy cleanup. So even if I were to just take a little bit, just put a little bit in the palette, and say I have this quantity on my brush. So even if I have to just apply a little bit of varnish on any of the beads and then clean it up, it's going to be easy. One of the important things again that I maintain for something like this is not to let the varnish dry on the bristles. Now what happens is I apply that both as for the paints as well as for the varnish. So the reason is that once it dries, you can try and get it off. You know, there, it's not that it's impossible. It's a little time consuming, but you can definitely get it off. But the fact is that in that process, there is a good chance that you're affecting the quality of the bristles, and a high chance that some of the bristles will just come out. It's best that you don't let this dry. As soon as your work of varnishing is done, it's best to go and clean this up immediately rather than waiting, for completing your entire project. No. If you have 10 beads to varnish, varnish all the 10 of them and then just immediately go and wash it. So let's go and wash this brush. It's a pretty simple soap and water cleanup, but I'll still show you how I get that done. So if you see, this is my varnish brush. I take a bowl, fill it with a little bit of hot water or warm water, add a few drops of the liquid soap, give it a good mix. I'm making sure at this stage I get rid of most of the varnish in the brush. I repeat the process, this time in my hands. I take a little more liquid soap and then just vigorously make sure I rinse the brush really well. This way, as it goes through a double rinse, making sure that the brush is free of any varnish, I take a paper towel and wipe it dry. And this is how I clean my varnish brush.
So you saw how I cleaned my varnish brush as well. One more thing is, it might be good for you to maintain a separate brush for your paints and a separate brush for varnish. It's just a better thing because obviously you don't want both of these products to mix. It just might be better to have a separate brush for varnish and a separate brush for your acrylic paints. Now, with regard to palette cleaning, also a necessary step in my opinion, but let me tell you that this is not something that I used to follow from the very beginning. I think definitely over time what has happened is that my own approach to how I should be treating my materials has changed a lot. Earlier, somehow, you know, when something is new, you always have a tendency to take extra care of it, but then once it starts getting old and you're just busy with your own work, you probably forget to take care of the most important set of tools that you have. I think at least in the last, I would say maybe a year or two, things have definitely become different for me. I have also tried to make sure that every material that I have, I treat it really well and not treat it just roughly. I usually tend to, even if I'm using, say, for example, a clay tool, I tend to wipe it down or wash it after work and then keep it back so that they don't dry with clay parts of basically bits of clay on it. And the same goes for brushes as well, and the same applies to the palette as well. So palette, what happens is that I'm sure in my earlier videos you've probably seen the palette of multi colors because the paint has dried on it and I've never really bothered wiping or scraping off the excess. So this actually is a daily practice, especially if you're somebody who actually paints on a daily basis. This is something that you can definitely use. This is very normal that the paint tends to dry out on the palette and you are left using your nails trying to scrape it off and everything. This probably the method that I basically use is I just use like an old toothbrush and some soap and warm water, and I just try and scrape it off and it comes clean, and I end up with a clean palette every time I start off. I think the idea of starting with a clean palette every time you want to start fresh makes a difference. At least it makes a difference for me. So let's see how I clean the palette.
So this is the palette, and if you see visibly, both the colors, both the paints have dried on them. So what I typically do is just apply a little bit of the dishwashing or the hand soap. Use an old toothbrush, something that I just use only for all this kind of cleaning and all that, and just, you know, do this. This tends to help quite a bit, but if you think that the stains are really stubborn, you can also try using some nail polish remover, but please don't use a nail polish remover on your paint brushes. You can try and use them on your palette. Because to me, I think using nail polish remover on your brushes can really affect the quality of the bristles. So if you see, it's all clean. I just wipe this with a paper towel and I have a clean palette.
Another little thing that I follow is never to get paint on the ferrule. Now, what happens in a lot of cases is that you end up with a lot of paint over here, which is very close to the bristle, you know, somewhere over here. It's like a big thick chunk of paint that just gets stuck over there, and we think it's not going to bother, but actually speaking, it does. With time, more and more paint gets accumulated over there, and it does affect the quality of the brush. So it's best that if you feel that paint is getting accumulated on this metal part over here, it's best to wash it off. I mean, even if it's dried, try to just scrape it off a little bit, you know, with your nails or whatever, and try to remove that off so that your brush, the ferrule, all the parts basically, the ferrule, the handle, everything is clean. Now that everything is pretty much covered, I think I've covered how I typically wash off the the paint when it's dry, when it's not dry, how I clean my varnish brush, how I clean my palette. So now I also said that I'll also show you how I typically store my brushes. Now I don't store them horizontal, I always store them vertical. So I have, like, obviously I'm pretty sure everybody has things like these. So it's you know, this is something like a pen stand, very convenient. The good part is none of the brushes are basically bending, or everything is just free out there. So that's what I tend to do. I usually tend to keep my liner brushes and my fan brush together like this. So it's just a lot more convenient to see it this way. And the fact that these brushes are not getting entangled with anything, they are not bent. So this is typically how I store it. I don't put a cap or anything of that sort on top of it. So that's pretty much it. Let me know what you think of the video. I think when it comes to brush care, I think I've pretty much covered everything that I am aware of and everything that I practice. So I think this has worked for me. The other thing is, on an average, I think, you know, you have to understand also, based on the quality of your brushes, you might have to invest on a new set maybe every few years if you're somebody who regularly paints. And that duration might even come down if you're somebody who paints on an everyday basis. Because sometimes what happens is, now if you're somebody who uses a liner brush very regularly, and you might feel that the bristles are probably thinning out, and you know, all those things are very common. So I think in those cases, you probably don't have a choice. You just have to go ahead and buy another set. I think that's what it is. Invest on decent quality brushes. I think they come a long way. There are some of them can be a bit pricey. I completely agree with that. But you will see that if you end up with, well, not so great quality brushes, you might probably have to, you know, replace them very soon. So I think this is it. I really hope you enjoyed the video, everyone. Please do let me know what you think of the video in the comment section. And as always, I'll get back to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for your time, and thank you so much for watching. Bye.